بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم ڈیئر اسٹوڈینٹس ایز یو نو دیٹ وی آر ڈسکسنگ اینڈ سالونگ آور ماک ٹو پیپر ون اینڈ وی ہیو ڈسکسڈ فیو کوشچنس فرام دس پیپر اینڈ وی ول کنٹینیو اور ڈسکشن فرام دا نیکسٹ کوشچن سو بوائز لیٹس موو ٹو دا نیکسٹ کوشچن آف Mock 2, Paper 1. Boys, up to now we have discussed first two questions. Now it is question number 3. Video streaming can use either interlaced coding or progressive coding. These are the two coding techniques, encoding techniques, which are used with the video streaming or video files. Name the video terms described below. These are related to videos and almost all the students have replied it wrongly. So no student is able to answer this question correctly. And it is very clearly written in the source material and it is very clearly explained to you by me these two terms, which I now tell you as an answer of these two question, two parts, very simple parts. Description: pixels in two different video frames have the same value in the same location, means there is a redundancy, duplication. There is a duplication of data between frames, means videos are two different videos, and there is the same value in the same location, means same frame name or same frame reference. And the second is a sequence of pixels in a single video frame have the same value, means now the video is one and in that single video frame some of the pixel have the same value, means there is again duplication, redundancy. So two terms are, one is called spatial redundancy, other is called temporal redundancy. So boys, see the marking scheme for this question. Very simple question. One mark for term. If two different video frames have the same value in the same location, then it is called temporal redundancy. Temporal redundancy. And if in a single video frame, some of the location in the frame have the same value, it is called spatial redundancy. So these are the two terms. Redundancy, you already know, means the duplication, repetition. So when the two video frames are different and pixel in those two video frames have the same value in the same location, it's called temporal redundancy. And if in a single video frame some pixel or a sequence of pixel have the same value, it is called spatial redundancy. So the next question. This question is taken from the communication, internet and communication technologies. Four communication media and five features are shown of these communication medias. Communication medias, you already know, can be wired, can be wireless. So in case of wired, it can be fiber optic, copper cable. In case of wireless, it can be radio wave, microwave, satellite communication. And in case of another wired communication media is a twisted pair cable used for the small network. So communication, four communication medias are given: fiber optic cable, radio waves, copper cable, satellite cable. You are not required to add any other. And some features are given: can be twisted pair or coaxial, transmit light pulses, large range of wavelength, least likely to have interference, wireless transmission. 100% understanding of these communication medias are there in your coursework, in your textbook, which we have studied and we have discussed this, and few students have replied it correctly. So 6 marks are given for this part. So in question, it is an examiner has given you the hint, draw one or more lines from each communication medium to the appropriate feature. What it means, more than one feature can be for one communication medium. So that is why 6 marks are given. So marking scheme of this fiber optic cable, we already know in the fiber optic cable, the light pulses are transmitted, data is transmitted with the speed of the light, and less likely to be to have interference, means some resistance, some interference in between the fiber optic communication, because it's a glass cable like communication. So 2 points related to that. Radio waves, large range of wavelength. Obviously radio waves have the large wavelength, and then it's a wireless transmission. Then the copper cable can be twisted pair or coaxial, right? Both has the copper inside. Coaxial cable is used in the cable transmission, and the twisted pair cable is mostly used in the computer networks. Only one description matched to this copper cable. Then the satellite, obviously wireless transmission, obvious. And then the satellite, large range of wavelength as with the radio waves. So this is 6 marks. Now boys, the next question. Downloading a file, question number 5. It has been asked, downloading a file from a website is an example of a client server application, means your server from where you are downloading the file, it's a server and you are the client. Describe what is meant by the term client server for this application. So when the communication is taken place between a server and a machine, then one machine is acting as a server, other is as a client. Data is usually kept on the server, and the client machine is requesting the data from the server with the help of the browser, and there are some other means also available. So we'll see the marking scheme as well. Boys, these are the 5 steps. You have studied these steps as well in the O levels. The following sequence of step 1 to 5 describe what happened when someone uses their personal computer PC to request a web page. We request from our PC, from our web browser to the web server, right? So what are the various kinds of communication take place between our computer and the web server, and web browser and the web server? So you have to mark them. The web page consists of HTML tags and text content only. Yes. 4 of the statement A, B, C, D, E, and F are used to complete the sequence. So this is the complete sequence A, B, C, D, E, F, and it is given for your guidance. And you have to pick from this table the correct sequence. Write one of the letter A to F in the appropriate row to complete the sequence. Right, the first is the user keys in the uniform resource locator, means the web page address or the website address in the web browser software. Then what should be the next step? You have to look it from the table and then write only the letter in front of 2, in front of 3, in front of 4, in front of 5, means this A, B, C, D, E, any one out of these. In the second step, browser software interpret the script and browser software render the page and display. So you have to think of the sequence and you have to write the answer for this part. So we will see the marking scheme of first 2 parts. because the third one is different from these two discussions. Question number 5, part A. You have two marks question. You have to give the two description for that. The file is made available from a web or email or FTP server. User browser is the client software on our machine. The client software means software browser requests the file from the server. Then the server is the other machine. So it is a communication between client means our web browser and the web server. The desired file is returned to the client computer. B. User key in the uniform resource locator, you are in the web browser software. Then the answer in 2, E. The domain name DNS uses the domain name from the browser to look up the IP address of the web server name. We always write the English version of the IP address, and that is being resolved by the DNS that we have already discussed and I have already explained it to you. So DNS is a distributed database application on the network which resolve the IP address issues. After that, when you get the numerical IP address, right, the web browser retrieved the page, the web server retrieved the page, send the web browser content to the browser. Then the web server send the content requested to the browser means F, and then browser software render the page and display. Browser software accept that page and display it on the screen. So these are the four letters in a sequence. Then E should be written in place of 2, then D, then F, then B, and all your correct reply will give you 1 mark each. So the next question. The following web page used for the data capture consists of 2 text boxes for the entry of a race runner ID code, their finishing position in a race, a button that the user clicked to submit this runner result. So this is the interface given of a page. Means these are the 2 inputs required. Runner ID you have to type, then the position, then this is the button to submit the data, to save the data. You have entered this data, you have saved. Then an alert is displayed before you, a JavaScript alert. Error, entry refused. Okay, so this is the code written for this type of interface. It's an HTML code. In this HTML code, Java is also embedded, right? What you have been asked, you are not required to write the code again, but you have to identify the various properties from this code. So the first one is asked, the developer has used 3 variables in the JavaScript code. State the identifier used. Boys, I have told you that the JavaScript starts from slash slash script. It starts from this place, and then for the variable, the var reserved word is used. Var output 1, var output 2, var runner ID. So these are the 3 variables used. Var stand for variable, output 1, then output 2, and then runner ID. So these are the 3 variables. And JavaScript start with the script and end with the slash script. HTML code start with the HTML in the tag and slash HTML to end the HTML code. The button has an event whose identifier is on mouse down. When the mouse button is clicked, some code is run. State the line number which contain this code. Boys, you have to see where this identifier on mouse down is written. See, boys, it's a line number 6, and then continued with where this piece of code is finished, this line number, this, right? So you have to identify the start and the end line numbers to get the full marks. If you have written one correct, you will not get any mark. The JavaScript code uses a selection statement, means the if statement, the condition statement, set the line number which contained that statement. You have to identify the line number, voice C, this is if, then in the 13, then else, and then end. Start in line number 13. Describe the purpose of the validation check that the code performed. A validation check is also written in this code. So you have to explain that what is, why this validation check is written in the Java code. So boys, it is written between the lines 13 and 21. And a hint is given to you, this one, CEM in double quotes, to identify the length of the runner ID. So you have to describe that. Name and describe two other validation check which could be appropriate for this data capture form. Boys, this is from your past knowledge and past study. We have the various definition, various validation check, means data validation check can include the range check, the format check, the consistency check, then the presence check, etc. So you have to suggest from you that what two other validation check can be used. You may choose any two, format check. You may use the range check to specify the range of the values to be input. So one mark for writing the validation check name, another marks for the description for which purpose you suggest there. Now boys, see the marking scheme of this. See part 1, the three variables are output 1, output 2, and the runner ID. Then the line numbers start from 6 to 21, the Java code. Then the 13, line number 13. Then the purpose of validation check checks that runner ID enters start with the character CEM. The hint is given to you in the code. Two validation check, one mark for you. You may select format check. Format check, runner ID is a three character letter followed by a two digit character. So this is format for each data input for the runner ID. Then the length check, runner ID has exactly five characters. Then the range check, the value position between one, say 30, some range of values. Present check means it is mandatory to write the runner ID, right? You cannot left it blank. Then the existence check, uniqueness check, you may select any two. That's all boys for this session. If you have any question or queries regarding these questions which we have discussed and their solution we have discussed, you may post it to my personal WhatsApp group nk-cbs-as-a-level. First, make sure that you post your queries on this WhatsApp group. This is I have created specially for AS and A-level students. Don't post your queries or comments on the WhatsApp chat on in your grade WhatsApp groups for computer science. Thank you very much, boys.